Hi, and welcome to JavaScript series. Today we will look at a couple of ways to loop through an array in JavaScript. Let's use this social array for iteration. It contains the name of few social channels. I'm using Chrome snippets in my browser to write the code, but feel free to write it in your favorite editor or on the browser console. We have this array containing the names of social channels. We declare it and add the values Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Snapchat. Now, our goal is to loop through every element in this social array and print that element. The first approach is to use for loop in JavaScript. The way to use it is by writing for var x is equals to 0, because you would like to iterate from 0th index and go until the last element of the array, which can be determined using length property of this social array. Increment the index each time by 1. So we will use console log to print on the console each element at index x from the social array. Let's run the code, and you can see it logs every element in this array. Now, the second approach is to use for each method available on arrays. To use for each, you need to pass a function as an argument, which will be executed on each element of this array. One of the parameters of this function is the current element in the array. So we pass to this function an argument channel, which is nothing but the current social channel. When this function executes, it logs every channel on the console. We'll run it again, and the same result. Now the third approach would be to use for of, which gives you the direct access to the element in an iterable, unlike the simple for loop we looked at. The for of loop came from ES6 specification. Here you simply need to declare a variable channel, which can be const because you are not modifying the channel variable. The keyword of is for the array social. So all we are saying here is for every channel of social array, log the channel value on the console. And that's it. Let's run it again, and we got the same results. So if you simply want to iterate through an array to access its elements, you can use any of these loops to do so. That's all I wanted to cover in this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.